Hello everyone, today I want to talk about one really fun lens which I received recently, and that lens is 7Artisans. This lens is really small and compact, that's why it's called BodyCap Lens. And let's talk about this lens. So let's start with the packaging. I received it inside of the plastic box and with the pouch inside, so that is whole complication. It seems like they tried to make it as affordable as possible, and right now the price for this lens is just $69. This is really affordable lens, and this is really simple lens in terms of design. This is not the first ever BodyCap lens. Fujifilm has one, Olympus has one, and there is some Kickstarter campaigns for the BodyCap lenses. But as far as I've seen reviews, this one is the best out of them, because it's just better in terms of image quality. Let's start with the specs. So this lens is a fixed focal length, it's 18mm, fixed aperture 6.3mm, and also it's fixed focus. It focused on infinity, and everything from 1.5 to 2 meters to infinity is decently sharp. Well, this is manual lens, if you can say so, because there is no controls on it. There is no electronic connections, so you won't get any EXIF information on your camera. About lens construction, it's 4 groups and 6 elements. I have no idea what does it mean. Built out of metal, everything out of metal and glass. And this small plastic decal with 7Artisan brand on it. Yeah, mount is metal as well. And there is 3 screws on the back, probably maybe to adjust some focus if you have some focusing issue with it, I'm not sure. Let's talk about the look of this lens. As I said, it's fully metal, and all I can say that there is quite a lot of writings. There is some Roman numbers and some scale. I don't know why they put it. Well, I can more or less understand why they put this basic information: 7Artisans, 18mm, 6.3 aperture, and by the way, it's called UFO lens. In my opinion, all these Roman numbers, this scale and this red triangle, it's not necessary, so they could leave it plain black and it would be better. So, but yeah, it doesn't really matter, it's just a look. Build quality, as I said, it's solid. Mounting is secure, so when you fit it on your camera, it doesn't move at all. Handling on this lens, well, there is no movable parts, you can't really adjust any settings on it. So as I said, everything is fixed. So you basically put it on your camera, and only things you're worried about is shutter speed and ISO. It makes your life a bit simpler, I would say. Let's talk about aperture. It's as I said, it's 6.3 aperture, and in my opinion, it's a good middle ground, because other BodyCap lenses, they would be something like f8 or f10, which is way too much, so you would have to raise your ISO really high. But with this one, you don't really have to raise it really high, and also everything in the focus. So I think it's a great balance, and you can actually use it on everyday basis. And if everything is in focus, it's really easy to use. You can just point and shoot. It just makes your decision making a bit faster. Of course, there is a negative point of it. Of course, there is no shallow depth of field. You can't really focus on something on foreground. And yeah, there is these limitations, and well, they're obvious. About focal length, 18mm, it's about 27 or 28 in APS-C cameras like Fujifilm or Sony, and would be something like 36 on Micro Four Thirds. So both of these focal lengths, they are quite popular for street photography, for documentary photography, for landscape photography. I think they made a good choice with the focal length and aperture. In other words, I think it's really usable lens. Of course, there is some limitations, and when you buy it, you should keep them in mind. As I've said, this lens is quite sharp, but of course you need to keep in mind that this is fixed focus on infinity, and that means that the field of the object, the sharper it's gonna be. The first time I got it, I made a test shot for about 1 meter from camera, and that wasn't sharp at all. It would pick up by focus picking, but it wouldn't be sharp. So I would say that you need to be 1.5–2 meters away from camera for this lens to perform the best, which is great for street photography. Yeah, I'll show some images with examples and with a center sharpness and corner sharpness so you can judge by yourself. I've made a quick test with this lens compared to the 18-55mm Fujifilm lens, which is I'm using right now to film this video. And I've shot both of them at 18mm at the similar aperture, and to be honest, I haven't noticed much difference in sharpness. There is a noticeable difference in contrast, but not really in sharpness. So I've shot a book on 1.5 meters away from camera, and yeah, you can see the result, one next to each other, and they're pretty similar. Well, there is no surprise that there is vignetting. It's 18mm, it's wide angle lens, it's quite often happens with them, and also the glass element is really small. I think it's kind of expected, but it's not terrible vignetting. It's easy to leave this. You can correct it in a post if you need, or well, I add vignetting anyway, so I don't think it's anything bad. Also, another thing I've noticed with this lens that you can take really nice macro images with this. I've used it with 26mm extension rings, and in my opinion, it's really sharp, and the magnification is just great. Obviously, when you have 26mm adapter on this lens, your focusing distance is really small, so 16mm is more usable. Well, depends what you need to shoot. So, in conclusion, for me, this lens is definitely usable, and especially for such thing as social media, Instagram, Facebook, wherever. For street photography, it's a great focal length, and image quality, yeah, it's more than enough. It's not for professional use, but there is gonna be some people, like me for example, who will like this lens and will love the fact that they can throw the camera in the pocket, for example, because, for example, when I go with my backpack, and I have to take off my backpack and get the camera, and well, it bothers me. And sometimes I decide not to take a shot just because I don't want to reach to the camera. And if I have this camera with this lens, there is much more opportunities for me to take images. For example, just when I go to work, for example, or from work. Well, yeah, you just need to know the limitation of this lens, and considering the price, I think it's worth to have it. This is a great little lens which is capable of good images. Here you can see image samples taken with this lens, and the most of them JPEGs out of the camera without any edits whatsoever. Mostly for stills. Thank you 7Artisans for sending this lens to me. I think it's really a lovely lens, and as I've said, I'm planning to use it. So hopefully it was helpful to you, and yeah, see you around.